Please like the video.
Now sit back, relax, and I hope you enjoy. Much love to all.
The Blackfoot lived primarily by hunting bison, fishing, and gathering berries and other plant food sources. Often several hunting groups would work together at favorable spots such as the head smashed in Buffalo Jump. Confrontation with the West. In 1851 they concluded their first treaty with whites in the United States, followed by a treaty with Canada in 1877. These treaties significantly limited their habitat. Together with the near extinction of the bison in 1871 and the introduction of new diseases by settlers, this dramatically changed the life of the Blackfoot. There is a difference in status between the leader and the common people. There is also a difference between men and women, but otherwise everyone is equal. There are no slaves or other subordinates to the people. Each people of the Blackfoot Nation has its own leader. This is why there are four leaders who discuss together what needs to be done. They meet and discuss most decisions. For example, the Blackfoot are largely autonomous from the American and Canadian governments and have their own laws and police. The leader mainly has administrative duties and plays only a limited role in the religion. Difference between man and woman. Although both sexes participate in music, religious rites, passing on lore, art and the performance of traditions, there is a division of labor between men and women. The women build the house, but it is their property. They have to cook and clean. They also bear the heaviest burdens when the people move. Men were hunters and warriors. Their main tasks are to provide food for the entire people and to protect the entire community from possible danger. Only men are allowed to become leaders. Due to the disappearance of hunting, they have lost an important task. Language. Blackfoot is an Algonquian language. The language is spoken by approximately 8,000 people. However, English is on the rise, which is at the expense of knowledge of their own language. Because hunting and gathering are insufficient means of subsistence, although they still play an important cultural role, the Blackfoot people live mainly from agriculture and livestock farming, some light industry and the making of traditional utensils for the tourist market. Blackfoot mythology. A story about Morningstar, the son of Sun and Moon, who fell in love with a girl from the Blackfoot tribe. Morningstar, in his scarlet cape and shiny black moccasins, descended to her, asked her to marry him, and took her up into the sky. The sun warned her never to look at her earthly home and she promised not to do so. She had a son, Little Star, with Morgenstern. In the teepee of her mother-in-law, the moon, a large iron cauldron boiled without a fire. The boiler had its own source that gave it heat. Her mother-in-law warned her never to move the boiler, but she did it anyway and through a hole she could see her former house. When the sun learned that she had disobeyed, she was sent back to Earth with her child. "You will never see your husband again," said the sun. They were wrapped in a caribou skin and lowered through the hole via a leather strap. The boy cut his face on the belt, so the tribe called him Poya, scarred face. One day Poya decided to travel to his father to get rid of the scar. He traveled for many months, came to the rocky coast and followed the path of light across the water into the sky. He lost his scar with his father. He returned to Earth and married his beloved, the chief's daughter.
Thank you for watching. I hope to see you again soon. Till the next time, much love.